In this video, everything you need to know when going on holiday to Santo Tomas in Menorca. If you haven't booked yet, then this is also a great video to find out if Santo Tomas is actually the right holiday destination for you in Menorca or not. In this video, I'm also going to share with you some tips that will save you a lot of money. Also, a few small things to watch out for, and as well, loads of tips that will make your holiday in Menorca in general even better. The beach in the Santo Tomas area is one large, long, sandy beach broken up into two separate pieces. The part in the front of the hotels is the developed one with sun loungers and bars next to it. The part of the beach in front of the villas in the more residential area has a more natural style feel. The best part here is in front of the restaurant as Brooks. It is normally the most peaceful here, but you still have some great food and drinks nearby as well. So what is there to see and do in Santo Tomas? Well, Santo Tomas really nearby is Son Marto Reyes. This is a great horse show, equestrian show. I haven't personally been here myself, but I heard a lot of good things about it while I was on the island, especially from families with younger children, let's say up till 12 years old. They really seem to have a great time here. So if you like this, definitely something to go and have a look at. Also, something that is very close by is the Montaña del Toro. From here, you have a great view over the entire area of Menorca, the entire island, and you can see all the different holiday destinations as well as a bit more of the island itself. You also have like a little bar restaurant up here, and there's also like a small chapel to go and visit if you want. So definitely drive up here or walk up here to have a great view of the area. Also near Santo Tomas, you can do loads of different water sports. You can go paddling, kayaking, there's little paddle boats as well. You can rent, there's loads of things. If you like water sports, also a lot of things you can do here from Santo Tomas. Santo Tomas doesn't really have the best connections with buses, so if you're trying to see a little bit more from the island, I would definitely advise you to rent a car. Renting a car is only about 20 euros with fully comprehensive insurance, so full coverage in case anything happens. This is also the way I rented it, and I even paid a little bit less because I was traveling early in season, 17 or 18 euros per day. Also, you can rent it much cheaper, but this is without the fully comprehensive insurance, then it costs like 12 euros a day. There's a lot of like tricky companies there that I wouldn't advise renting with. This isn't the Menorca thing. It's happening more and more in other places I've traveled to. The company I would advise you to rent with, which I got these great prices with and great service and no unpleasant surprises, you can find on my website at checkedholidays.com/cars. When it comes to restaurants in Santo Tomas, most of them you will find close to the beach. There's also a few in the back streets, but there really ain't so much variety here. Most of the hotels cater to an all-inclusive audience, so you won't really find so much choice here when it comes to restaurants. When it comes to hotels in Santo Tomas, know that Santo Tomas has some of the nicest, newest and most modern hotels in Menorca. One of these that I can definitely advise is the E55 Santo Tomas. It's a great hotel, a little bit in the back with great views and very modern and clean vibe. If you want to see the full list of hotels I would advise on Menorca, then do know that during my time in Menorca, I visited over 80 of the best hotels on the island and picked 15 of the best ones. I covered this in a different video. I'm not going to spend time on this in this video, but I have all of this covered in another video as well. You can find the full list on my website at checkedholidays.com. So when is the right time for you to visit Santo Tomas, and how will be the weather in Menorca at that time? Well, I definitely wouldn't advise to visit in November or December because these are the coldest, wettest and most windy months on Menorca. So definitely not something I would advise. January, February, March and April are also very cold months, also not definitely beach weather. Towards the ending of April, you could take a little bit of a risk if you find a very good deal, but know that still most of the hotels and restaurants and bars in Santo Tomas at that time will be closed. In May, normally most of the hotels in Santo Tomas start to open and most of the restaurants and things are open as well. Know that this is a great month to go on a budget, especially in the first weeks of May. You can still find some really good deals. The weather is starting to change, it's starting to get hotter, it's starting to come less rain, but do know that you are still taking a little bit of a risk, especially in the beginning weeks of May when it comes to weather.
In my opinion, June and September for most people, if you have the opportunity to go in these 2 months, are normally the best times because the prices are reasonable, the good weather is pretty much guaranteed, everything is open on the island, it's a great time to go. July and August are normally the hottest months on the island, and also in Santo Tomas it is the same. Do know that the weather is going to be very hot, some days can be even a little bit humid feeling and uncomfortable, but normally this is also the days that you have the most sun and the hottest temperature. So if you're really looking for a beach holiday or a poolside holiday, these are normally the best months to come to Menorca. So what is the best way of getting from the Menorca airport to Santo Tomas? Well, there's quite a few different ways, but one way would be to take the public transportation. The public transportation means that you have to take the bus from the airport to Mahon and then from Mahon to Santo Tomas. This together will cost you €2.65 to get to Mahon and €3.25 to get to Santo Tomas. So altogether, calculate about €6 to take the bus to Santo Tomas. Do know that you have to transfer in Mahon and that this connection can take quite a while to show up, so it will take also quite long, so do keep this in mind. Another more direct way that will also drop you off at the hotel reception and not at some random bus stop in the middle of nowhere where you don't know where to go is to book a shuttle before online. The shuttles, they do cost a little bit more, but you don't have to transfer. You get dropped off at the reception and there's also a lot more benefits that they will wait for you if your flight is delayed and things like this. So do keep all of this in mind. The shuttle will cost you about €11 and is definitely on a budget, or if you're traveling one or two people, a great way to get to Santo Tomas. Another way to get to Santo Tomas from the Menorca airport is to take a taxi. Taxis are great value for money if you're traveling three or four people, because it comes almost the same price as the shuttle bus and it takes you there in a more direct line and more easy. Do know that the price as mentioned at the airport is €37, but that this is only an estimate, so it can go up, and also in weekends or in the evenings it gets more expensive. For both shuttles and taxis, I would always advise you to book before online for shuttles because you have to, and for taxis you get a lot of extra benefits because if you're traveling more than four people, you have the possibility to take a 5-people taxi or 6-people taxi, and also you have a locked-in price, so you always know in advance what you're gonna pay, so no surcharges for weekends or anything like this. You can find all the links to the companies I used and would advise on my website at checkedholidays.com/links. So before I continue, I quickly also want to add a little bit of a cheeky tip. This is, I have many more videos covering Menorca here on my channel on YouTube. If you want to find all of those as easy as possible, then don't forget to click the subscribe button. But also about all the other Balearic Islands and Canary Islands, all the islands in Spain, I also have other videos. If you want to find out more about those, also hit that subscribe button to find those even more easy. Menorca is a really nice place, but there's a few small things I do want to give you a warning about. This is if you're traveling from the beginning of October till the ending of May, anywhere in this period, it can get quite windy. So if you're traveling in this period, definitely bring a jumper or a jacket, especially in the evening, it gets quite cold on these windy days. Because of the wind, it can also sometimes feel like it's not as hot as it really is, or the sun ain't shining that hot. I travel to a lot of different places, always sunny places. I don't easily get burned, but in Menorca I did get burned. Simply said, put on sunscreen no matter if it feels hot or not, because otherwise you might get an unpleasant surprise. Menorca the last few years has been having a bit of a problem with jellyfish. Just like the other Balearic Islands, there's coming more and more jellyfish. Many of the jellyfish are quite harmless. The other ones, they do cause a pretty bad sting. So always check before in the water if you see any jellyfish. If you're not 100% sure, talk to the lifeguard, or also at the lifeguard tower, they always have information if there's any jellyfish or not.
If you're not completely sure that this is the right holiday destination for you in Menorca, know that you can click right here. This will take you to a page on my website where I have a quick comparison of all the different holiday destinations in Menorca, and you can quickly find out which one is the right one for you, as well as which one are the right hotels for you to stay at. If you don't want to do that, you just want to stay on YouTube and watch some other videos, then you can also have a look at any of these other videos of mine.